What is going on, everybody? I am Mike. Welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. I'm glad that you're with me today because I've got a problem that I think you can relate to. I'm the owner of a new M1 Mac Mini, and the problem with the M1 Mac Mini, same goes for the MacBook Pro, goes for the iMac, it goes for all the M1 chips actually, including the iPad Pro, is that they are limited in the number of I/O that you can connect to this device. Well, if you are anything like me, you need a number of ports, and really the two Thunderbolt ports that are on those devices just doesn't cut it. Today's video, I'm going to review the Echo 11 Thunderbolt 4 dock from Sonnet Technologies to tell you if it's worth $319 they are charging for it. Let's get started. Before we get in the review, let's baseline our knowledge on what the differences are between Thunderbolt 3 and Thunderbolt 4 so we can properly evaluate this dock. Many think that just because the number is higher, Thunderbolt 4 is superseding Thunderbolt 3, and that is simply just not the case. Both Thunderbolt 3 and Thunderbolt 4 are designed and intended to coexist simultaneously. There are many similarities between the two. First, they both use the USB-C connector. They both have a line bandwidth of 40 gigabits. They also support PCIe tunneling, DisplayPort tunneling, and have a maximum of 6 devices that could be in the Thunderbolt chain. The cables themselves are interoperable, meaning I could take a Thunderbolt 4 cable connected to a Thunderbolt 3 device, vice versa, and I'm gonna get the same throughput and performance as I would. The Thunderbolt 3 and Thunderbolt 4 devices can be mixed, and they can be in any order in the chain itself. It doesn't necessarily matter that it's Thunderbolt 3 first or Thunderbolt 4 first. Now, if you want to see more great accessory videos, plus you want to see my full review of iPadOS 15 and iOS 15 when it drops in a very few weeks, make sure you are subscribed. Click that notification button right down there so you can be alerted when that video drops. There are some differences in the amount of power that you can charge your upstream computer. Like if you're connected to your Mac, it might only charge 85 watts or 90 watts depending on the dock itself. Even though they are designed to be interoperable and coexist in a mixed environment, there are some differences. So here, this is the CalDigit TS3, and this is a Thunderbolt 3 dock with one upstream port connecting to your computer and then a downstream port in addition to a HDMI, or in this case, is a DVI. Now, both the DVI and the downstream Thunderbolt port are connected to the same Thunderbolt controller. When we compare that to a Thunderbolt 4 dock that has three downstream interfaces, these interfaces have a shared PCI resource, which means is one of these resources could hog technically all the bandwidth for communicating, and it would impact any of the other resources that are on this device. That is a little bit different than the Thunderbolt dock, where all four PCIe lanes are dedicated to the downstream Thunderbolt port. Now let's get a look here at the Echo 11 Thunderbolt 4 dock. Open this up. These were kind of hard to find, but I was able to get my hands on one. We have a quick start guide. All right. We have a very beefy power cable. We have a 0.7 meter Thunderbolt 4 cable. Here is the AC adapter. And that is it. So not a whole lot in the box. Now that's as clear as mud, let's talk about the actual interfaces on the Echo 11 Thunderbolt dock. Now it's called the Echo 11 because there are 11 interfaces. Here on the front, there's an SCHC Type 2 card reader. There's a 1.5 amp fast charger. There's a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. You also have the upstream port to charge your Mac or your Windows machine, which is capable of delivering 90 watts. There is a power LED and then a link LED, which will illuminate when it's connected to your computer. And then there's a power button. The power button is which I like because my current Thunderbolt 4 dock from OWC does not have a power button. That blue light is always like that. Now in the back, there's a 20 volt 6.75 amp charger. There are three Thunderbolt 3 ports, which are each capable of delivering 40 gigabits per second, and they will deliver 15 watts of charging. There's a gigabit Ethernet port, and then three high-speed USB-A ports, all capable of delivering 10 gigs per second. Now, it is an all-metal enclosure. It's got a nice feel to it. Sounds nice. It's, you know, it's definitely beefy for the $319. Now, the question you have to ask yourself, does it offer anything significantly different over the OWC dock? I would say for $279. I mean, it's a $50 difference. What you're paying for, you know, what is it? And in my estimation, there's really no difference between these two docks that warrant the $50. Maybe you like the metal enclosure. That could be meaningful. Maybe you like the button on the dock. Again, that could be meaningful depending on the type of environment that you're in. But I would say that both docks function the same. Both docks have the same ports, the same port bandwidth. I mean, they're almost identical. And I would think that the same company is designing and manufacturing these docks for both OWC and for Sonnet as well. Now, if you're looking to get this dock because you want to increase the number of displays that you have on your MacBook Pro, your Mac Mini, your iMac, know that this dock will not help you with that. This is only a dock and it does not have the ability to push more than one display, which is a limit of the graphics card or the GPU on those devices. The reason why the Mac Mini supports an additional display is because there is a HDMI plug that is on the back of the Mac Mini is directly connected to the M1 chipset inside of it. It does not use the GPU. So that is why you can use two displays here. Now, a couple things to keep in mind. If you're looking to connect high bandwidth accessories, maybe you have a RAID drive, maybe a 10 gig Thunderbolt drive, you would not want to use the Thunderbolt 4 dock in these scenarios because those types of accessories require more lanes of PCIe than what this has available. And if, again, if you connect that to this dock and maybe you had an external SSD, maybe you had a RAID drive that you were connecting to this, they're going to be competing for resources and you're going to create a bottleneck. So that's the thing I'd keep in mind. I would still use Thunderbolt 3 in that instance because, again, Thunderbolt 3 docks, like the CalDigit TS3, has four lanes of PCIe dedicated to that downstream Thunderbolt port. So those are things to keep in mind. Now, I am Mike. Let me know if you have any questions down in the comments below. If you have anything else that you'd like me to test, I'm very active. And if you found value in this video, consider hitting like, sharing it with someone, because the algorithm does like that. It's actually more helpful than you think. I'll talk to you guys in the next one.